here same for particle on a sphere, that is rotation of a diatomic molecule with axis of rotation is also moving. We had seen it two things. One, when the axis of rotation was kept fixed or constant, so that theta we had kept it constant. In the first instance, we had kept theta constant as theta is equal to zero, aligned to z-axis. And in the second case, we had seen that we had varied theta also, as theta as a variable. And so when theta was variable, we could get it from a spherical harmonics, the energy equations, and we got the energy equation as beta x square upon 8 pi square I, where we had seen that the beta takes values of L into L plus 1, where L is a quantum number. So as it is a rotational motion that is undergoing, so L can be replaced by J as a rotational quantum number. So we get the equation for energy as E is equal to J into J plus 1, x square upon 8 pi square I. So this will be the equation for rotational motions. Now let us see some problems based on it. Let us have first problem. Consider HBr, hydrogen bromide, as a rigid rotor with internuclear distance of 147.1 picometers. Calculate the rotational energy for J is equal to 1, that is first rotational energy level. Given atomic mass of bromine as 79 and that of hydrogen as 1. So you have been provided with mass of bromine as 79, mass of hydrogen as 1, then we have been provided with J is equal to 1, and also R has been given to you as 147.1 picometer, which can be converted to meters as 147.1 into 10 raised to minus 12 meters.
Yes,
if you substitute this in our equation as E is equal to J into J plus 1, x square upon 8 pi square I, you will get in this particular energy level. Yahan pe I ka value hume mil sakta hai from masses and from R value, that is mu R square. So this can be written as mu is M1 M2 upon M1 plus M2, so it will be 79. डायरेक्टली हमें 79 लेना है, ये क्या करना है इसका, म्यू हम कैसे कैलकुलेट करेंगे, रिड्यूस्ड मास इज एम वन एम टू अपॉन एम वन प्लस एम टू, बट दीज आर इन एसआई यूनिट्स बिकॉज बाकी सब हम एसआई यूनिट्स में ले रहे हैं, सो मासेस शुड ऑल्सो बी एसआई यूनिट्स. एसआई यूनिट ऑफ मास इज किलोग्राम्स. And these are
H
in grams, so we will have to convert them into kilograms by multiplying with 10 raised to minus 3 into, this is for bromine, for hydrogen divided by bromine plus hydrogen into 10 raised to minus 3 as a common for both of them. Now we have to do, this is our masses for gram atomic number, these are gram atomic masses. So for one atom it will be divided by Avogadro's number, is 6.023 into 10 raised to 23, and then R square is 147.1 into 10 raised to minus 12 square. So this will be giving us the moment of inertia. यहाँ पे Avogadro's number से हम divide करते हैं because ये जो मासेस है हमारे, ये मासेस हम लेते हैं वन फॉर वन मोल, इट इज मोलर मासेस, सो दीज आर फॉर वन मोल ऑफ एटम्स दैट वी आर टेकिंग द मास, सो वी हैव टू डिवाइड इट बाय एवोगाड्रोस नंबर. एक्चुअली ईच वन ऑफ देम हैज टू बी डिवाइडेड बाय एवोगाड्रोस नंबर, लेकिन यहाँ पे एक एवोगाड्रोस नंबर इधर से इधर में कैंसिल हो जाएगा, सो इट विल बी जस्ट वन अपॉन 6.023 इनटू 10 टू 23 विल बी रिमेनिंग देयर. दिस विल बी 79 into 1, that is 79 into 10 raised to minus 6 divided by 80 into 10 raised to minus 3. 80 into 10 raised to minus 3. Into 147 into 147 into 10 raised to minus 24. So that can be written as 2116384 into 10 raised to minus 20 divided by 6.023 into 10 raised to 20. (3.55) into 10 raised to minus 47 units, it should be kilogram meter squared. Without units, this has no meaning, and it is mass into distance square, so it will be kilogram meter squared. So we have calculated I value. Now we will be calculating E values. E value we will calculate it by using this particular formula. E is equal to J into J plus 1. So E will be equal to J is 1. So 1 into 1 plus 1 into 6.626 into 10 raised to minus 34 square divided by 8 into pi square 3.14. into 3.14 into I is 3.55 into 10 raised to minus 47. So this should give us the value for E. Yes, 3.13 into 10 raised to minus
22.
Units, joules. It has to be joules. 3.13 into 10 raised to minus 22 joules. I had got it 3.138 into 10 raised to minus 22 joules for the first energy level of HBr. We change the molecule, then our I value will change. And so I value, as the I value changes, it will be a different energy levels will be obtained for it. You can have two more problems. You will solve one, the other you solve it at homework. For this problem, consider a carbon monoxide molecule as a rigid rotor. The internuclear distance is given as 1.131 angstrom. Calculate the rotational energy level for J is equal to 2. This is very much similar to what we had it for first one. Third problem is also similar. Calculate the energy of second rotational energy level, J is equal to 2, in the molecule of nitrous oxide having internuclear distance of 110 picometers. So in NO molecule, we have to find out the energy levels for second rotational energy level, that is J is equal to 2. Equation will remain same as E is equal to J into J plus 1 H square upon 8 pi square I, where we have been provided with J is equal to 2. Also R is given to us as 110 picometers. We can convert it into 110 into 10 raised to minus 12 meters. Masses for nitrogen, we can take it as, which is the most abundant for nitrogen? 14. We'll have it for 14. And mass of oxygen as 16. So we will have, we can just substitute these values over here. First, calculate the value of I, that is 14 into 10 raised to minus 3 into 16 into 10 raised to minus 3 upon 14 plus 16 into 10 raised to minus 3 1 upon 6.023 into 10 raised to 23, 110 into 10 raised to minus 12 can be written as 1.1 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter square. This should be giving us the moment of inertia values. I'm getting 1.50069 into 10 raised to minus 46 kilogram meter square. थोड़ा सा डिफरेंस हुआ, थर्ड डिजिट में यहाँ पे तो चल जाता है, सेकेंड डिजिट, सेकेंड डेसिमल, थर्ड डेसिमल में थोड़ा डिफरेंस आया तो चलेगा. 1.350 का 1.51 हुआ, ये 1.52 या 1.48 चलेगा, बट 1.36 इतना ज्यादा डिफरेंस थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम हो जाएगा, क्योंकि फाइनल आंसर में फिर डिफरेंसेस काफी ज्यादा आ जाते हैं. कहाँ पे गलती हुआ देख लो एक बार. Then we have E, energy levels we need to calculate. That is 2 into 2 plus 1, 6.626 into 10 raised to minus 34 square divided by 8 into 3.14 square into I, that is 1.50069 into 10 raised to minus 46. This is our 6 into इसका स्क्वायर होगा 43 और 43.9038 into 10 raised to minus 68 divided by ये सारा जो होगा that will be 1.1837 into 10 raised to minus 44. 118.37 into 10 raised to minus 46, that can be simplified to minus 44. Into 10 raised to minus 20, minus 24, 22. This will be 24. It will be 2.23 into 10 raised to, or it will be 223.24 into 10 raised to minus 24. So this can be written as 2.2324 into 10 raised to minus 22 joules. So in this way, we can solve the problems based on rotational quantum numbers or the rotational energy levels. We can easily find it out.